I welcome all of you to this course, Fundamentals of Combustion. So, what are the applications of combustion? If you look at, I can broadly divide it into four categories,
right?
Okay. What are those? Can anybody tell me? For example, I can say power plants, you know, power generating power. Right, for generating power. I need to have power today. Without that, you cannot really live a life. Okay. But there are people who are not depending on power. You are aware? There are some people in, you know, tribal people who are staying deep jungles. They are not depending on power. Right? Yes or no? They are more intelligent than you, or you are more intelligent than them? Think about it. And once you generate power, you will have to also pollute, and you will also won't get, you know, you won't go to bed early in the morning, right? Or you will go to bed early in the morning. Are you getting my point? So that light is there. If light were not there, electricity were not there, what good are you going to go to sleep? So your lifestyle has been changed, and it is spoiling your body, mind and spirit. So automobiles, of course, we'll have to move around, transportations, right? And which is very important, if you look at, I have shown a figure here, tractor. Tractor has created a havoc so far agriculture is concerned. Yes or no? It has spoiled the soil, and then farmers are committing suicide, okay? And then all those things, you people may not be very much concerned. But please be concerned about the other people as well. And chemical industry, because today modern world without chemical technology, it's very difficult to sustain. Okay, so therefore, and the another things, you know, like is the domestic applications very much. If you look at here, I have shown you a LPG burner. We will be discussing more about it, and so if you look at this figure I have shown, can anybody tell me what is this figure? Any idea? Petrochemicals, right? And then we also spoil the sea, oil spilling and other things, right? So this is inside sea, okay? This figure shows to you. So let us look at the scope of combustion. If you look at, I am giving you, you know, bird's eye view of the application of combustion. It's not that all I will be discussing, right? So if you look at industrial processes, there are several of them. Like for example, chemical plants. You know, like sugar industries. UP is known as a what you call sugar bowl of India, but not no more today, and now it is a Maharashtra. So sugar is a very important, of course the sugar has spoiled us there. Do you agree with me? Sugar has spoiled our body and mind and getting more diseases. And means sugar means what? Sugar, like whatever you are taking, the white color, very nice crystals, you know, like man made crystals, not, you know, nature made crystals. And those are not good for health, but if you go to the good, a jaggery, what they call, that is very good, okay? But we lost the technology of making jaggery, indigenous technology. So food processing industries, and all of you are very much happy with the processed food, but if you take processed food, you will spoil your body and pay more money. And similarly, iron, steel, other metals, you know, any other metal except aluminium are being processed basically from the raw materials, using the combustion route because it is cheaper. You will go for electricity, it will be very costly, okay? And heat treatments, annealing of metals, and then even like cement, Portland cement, if you look at, you know, is basically made using the rotary kilns. And let me tell you also, I am against the Portland cement because it is spoiling the environment. The best way of making house is chuna, lime, Okay. So, food processing and then all those things are there. But I must tell you that we are a part of this industrial revolution which was started something 1760, and we are still continuing. This industrial revolution really spoiled India to a large extent. Why? Because we lost our indigenous technologies. Today companies are having what? Companies are having the technology. Common people are paupers. They do not have any knowledge. Am I right? Our society is other way around. Our society is that common people should have requisite knowledge for living a life. They don't depend on others. There is a diametrically opposite philosophy of what Western people think and what we think, what our ancestors think, not we, right? So therefore, we need to think about how we'll develop the technology, particularly the combustion technology, which will be useful for the people, not for industry. Industry will use is okay, but this would not loot us. So, and also spoil our beautiful earth, the environment what we are having. So we should keep that in mind. So, if you look at, I have taken some engines here, right? If you look at, this is basically a which engine? Piston, cylinder engine, right? It can be diesel engine, it can be gasoline engine. I can use also biodiesel. I can use also various other gas like producer gas and other gas CNG. I can use this piston engine. And this is your also a gas turbine engine. In that, this is your combustors, right? And both are internal combustion engine, right? Because the combustor is a part of the entire engine. It is inside. Similarly, here the combustion will be taking place, right? Combustion will be taking place in this place or not? Yes or no? This is a piston, this is a cylinder, in between will be occurring. Of course, this is a spark ignition engine, SI engine. But in place of spark ignition engine, you can put a injector, diesel injectors, and then you can use, you can of course change the location depending on your design and also its utility. So, if you look at what are these are the what you call workhorse, because you know of the power plant, because this is a power plant, you can say for particularly transportation sectors which is being used, and this can be also used for the generating electricity, right? Both the engines can be used for generating electricity also. Like transport, you know, as I told, the surface transport vehicles are operated by reciprocating IC engine, right? Of course, in Western country, the people are using gas turbine for certain trucks and other things they are saying. And gas turbine combustor is used widely in air and marine transportation sectors. So, if you look at this is basically, you know, this car and then other vehicles. Of course, this is your locomotives, right? Rail engine that can be used, your aircraft, ships and other things. So, space transportation, if you look at, generally chemical rocket engines are used profusely for space transportation, and we are having a very good program. ISRO is doing successfully lot of launching of the space vehicles, not only you know putting a satellite, but also the deep space missions like you know Mangaljan and then Chandrayaan, other thing. So we are having a very vibrant programs, and of course in recently you know the scramjet engines which have made the you know news that we are having, and which considered as an advance air breathing engines. This is ISRO's high speed air breathing propulsion system, scramjet engine, right? And of course, the ramjet is also being used, that is of course not for transportation, but for the missile applications. And in this case, if you look at basically the fuel will be injected here, and then the combustion will be taking place, then it will be expanded in a nozzle. So therefore combustion is very important, you know, like to devise, you know, systems for transportation. The power generation, most of the thermal power plants are operated by the burning of coal, right? Is it true? Actually, it is not that true today. It was, you know, let us say 30 years back it was true. Today around maybe 60 to 70% of the power are generated by the burning of coal. Rest are, you know, being done by the nuclear, by the non-conventional energy, by the diesel power and other things, right? And gas turbine power plants are also in India. And these thermal power plants, there are several technologies. If you look at this, the coal power plants, where traditional, you know, boiler will be there, right? And this is your boiler. There are various kinds of boiler there, and these are powder coal being used to burn that thing, and it is a fixed blade grate combustion which will be taking place in this, and steam turbine being used. But there is a recent time, this is a fluidized bed, you know, combustor will be taking place, because the air will be used, fluidized air, where the particulates, coal particulates will be floated, will be fluidized, so that it will be suspended in the air and you can have a better combustion. And also this is a circulating bed, fluidized bed combustors, which will be circulate the particulates, so that, you know, particulates will be not getting into atmosphere that extent what it will be occurring in the traditional power plant. And there is also biomass based power plant, because it is coming up well, and there is a lot of problem associated with the coal, particularly Indian coals. If you know, like we are having a coal which will be containing large amount of what? Certainly no. Sulfur basically, you know, will be there in coal, and which are coals are being, those coals which are being used by China, right? And whereas our coals will be containing large amount of ash, right? That is a very big challenge. For that, you know, fluidized bed technology is required, and also the when you use this hybrid kind of, what you call, coal and then biomass together, then you can overcome that problems. So of course the biomass is the another way of generating power using in the boiler. And there is a, of course, the gas turbine power plant. You can combine this to a combined cycle, you know, coal, gas turbine and then coal, so that together you can enhance the efficiency of the systems and also the emission. So there is a lot of technology of power plant which are coming up, and then of course we are not the leaders. We should do, you know, ourselves, so that we will be ahead of them. And the waste disposal is a very important aspect, right? Because of fact that we are producing more waste than the anything else. Because of modern life, we are producing more waste per person. If you look at it, is in Kanpur, I was told something per day around 150 grams per person, you know. I may be wrong, I will be happy to be wrong. That is the waste we are producing, because of packing foods and then lot of other things, packaging, you know, that is the waste. Now this waste disposal was started when? Any idea? Indians were very good in disposing the waste in ancient time. For example, dead bodies, okay, dead bodies also a waste. And India was a populous country earlier also. So therefore, if a dead body is there, I cannot put into the ground, then it will be creating more havoc. Why? Because there will be bacteria development, other things, you know, it will be contaminated, more disease will spread. If I burned it, all will go. So therefore, the, you know, incineration of the dead bodies is being taking place since time immemorial. Am I right or wrong? So therefore, we were doing earlier, but unfortunately, we have not kept those things with time. Those things technology has to change. We are having so many engineers, but we have not come up a combustion technology for what you call burning the dead bodies, right? And it is a part of our culture, but we should do that. And combustion find applications in disposing waste material. Incinerators are used to dispose both domestic and industrial waste, right? You might be knowing that keeping the incinerator in a hospital is a must today by law, but unfortunately, most of the private hospital, even some of the government hospital, do not have incinerators, right? But so I have shown you a incinerator here, where you can have human body and then even plastic, you know, you can incinerate, which is a very deadly material, and industrial waste, municipal waste, and hospital waste, and even you can use used tire. You know, tire is also waste, right? So therefore, it is a very important aspect which need to be designed and developed so that we can, you know, dispose our waste. Otherwise, we cannot be a Swachh Bharat, right? Clean India, green India, right? How can we possible unless we find out the technology and the meet or what you call clear the things what is created by this what you call companies and industries, because they are the things which are producing this all this waste, right? We'll have to clean because we are consuming their products. Yes or no, right? So therefore, otherwise we'll have to face the problem. So fire is the genesis of life, as I told. It can also you know, destroy our life. So forest fire, you might be aware, there is a story in Mahabharat, right? There is a fire. You are aware?
Yes.
You people might not have read Mahabharat, okay? So right, the fire also at that time there was there. It's not that today fire is there. Of course, the today very less number of forests are there in this country, and fire is less likely to occur then. But however, fire, the forest has to be protected, and so all has to, we'll have to avoid the forest fire. Similarly, there is a dust explosion which is taking place because we are producing lot of dust. There might be explosion also. The structural fire, you know, like you might be seeing high-rising building, and earlier days the thatched house were being used in villages, right? How they were managing the fire? Fire, I have seen also when I was a kid, the you know, thatched house or thatched house, right? The fire, and oil spill fire is a big problem, right? And so also the several other fires like your lab fire. Like is a very important, that also occurs, and as I told that it is very important to develop the device how to arrest the fires and to avoid the fire hazard, and by using proper construction material and fire hazard can be minimized. Even the marine life is very much affected by oil spill fire. We need to see, I'll tell you, the modern technology is really causing a havoc, and my always suggestion that use minimum the technology and the live with the nature maximum, like maximize and have a relationship with the mother nature is more important than the going away from her. So at the same time, we'll have to use something. It's not that we should not use. And there is a domestic application. If you look at the cooking stove I have shown here, right? This is basically traditional wood stove, right? Now any of you have used this wood stove? You have used? Oh, three of you have used traditional wood stove. My god, I am very happy. Oh, fourth half also. But I will tell you how you will ignite it. That is the question now, if you have used it. I want to initiate the fire. How I'll do it?
By blowing air.
No, you cannot. It's difficult. Kerosene. Suppose kerosene is not there in ancient time.
We have dry woods.
Yes. Not dry woods also you cannot. Okay.
Dry leaves.
Yes. That is the. Otherwise, when I was a kid, we used to, because this was a job given to me by my mother. Right. So, I'll have to ignite. We used to use the paper. At that time, paper was there. Paper is easier to do. Right. So, it's very difficult. And particularly rainy season like now, it's very difficult to maintain this. Right. Now, later on, of course, you know, this is a wood stove. Right. What is it condensed? What kind of, what is the difference between both? Any idea? This one I am talking about here. This is basically coal. Okay. Now, why you might be thinking this is a very simple thing we are talking about application wise, but it is very important because without food you cannot survive. Okay. Our Shastra says Anne Pratishta Deva. That means food is important. Okay. And whatever you people are doing, whatever all people are doing, for what? For food. But at the end of the day, what kind of food you get? Do you know? All pesticide, insecticides, and then chemicals which are bad for health. Are you getting? You purchase from market and most of the market, and then you use food, processed food, it will be more dangerous. Right. So, now this is another stove I have shown. You have seen this kind of stove here? What kind of stove it is? Kerosene. So, how it is being burned? This flame is there here. Any idea? No idea. Huh? What you are saying? I couldn't get.
There is a pin and then.
Pin? No. It is a weak flame. Do you know what is a weak? Is a cotton strips and then put it and then kerosene weak flame, right? And this whatever you are saying, this is a basically kerosene stove also, right? Here what is happening? What is happening? There will be a jet, liquid jet, right? And it will be atomized and spray will be coming and then will burn. That means this is, for that what I'll do? I'll have to pressurize it. Any of you have used this thing? This one? Right? You'll have to use pressure. If pressure will be reduced, then it won't burn properly. Right. So, now this is your LPG stove. That you are aware. Okay. And it is not only LPG, you can use PNG, you can use CNG. You know what is PNG? What is CNG? Pipe natural gas, compressed natural gas, CNG. Or you can use biogas, we can use some other things, you know. But of course, the design might be different. Now, what will be the power range of these stoves? Any idea? What will be power? Is it maybe 0.5 kilowatt, whether 1 kilowatt? Or whether 2 kilowatt or 2.5 kilowatt or 4.5 kilowatt, 5 kilowatt, what will be the range? Of course, do not think that, you know, what will be the range of? For example, let us say you want to buy a LPG stove, right? And you go and say, okay, I want two, you know, two stoves will be there. One is small, other is big. So, what is the power of small? What is the power of big? Any idea? Okay, let me tell you, because you people may not be aware. One is 2.5 kilowatt, other is 5 kilowatt. Okay, find out. But check it. If it is not right, please get back to me. Okay. Don't go by me, because I always tell, don't follow me, follow the truth, follow the logic. Okay. Now, you are given a chance to cook food, okay, and you want to make it tasty. So, which stove you will choose out of this? These are the options are given. Any idea? Because you want to make the food tasty, isn't it? And it will be nutritious, right? Any idea? Which one?
Minimum power.
No, all are same power, let's say. Assume it is all same power. I have designed that way. LPG will give you tastier food, right? Yes or no? Agree? No idea?
Depending on the mode we are using the LPG.
No, all are LPG. I am using same power level, na? Where mode comes into picture?
Less. Then sometimes you use less flame, sometimes you use.
I am telling the same power means flame will be same, you know, then only. Suppose there is a solar cooker here, okay, and I am adding, I have not put this figure because it is not a part of combustion, and which will be tastier? Solar cooker 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and solar cooker. Which will be tastier?
Put
solar cooker. Why?
We need energy without any
combustion. No, you have not understood. Solar cooker will be tastier, that is true. It is a uniform. No, rate of heating plays an important role. Rate of heating, right? Any of have given any of you have gone to the this one, what you call Puri Jagannath temple, have taken the food there which is cooked, and it will be very tasty. Even same rice you will come and you know cook it in your home, it won't be that tasty. People say it's Jagannath. I told no, it is a technology. Okay. Are you getting? So, I will tell you that rate of heating in which it will be low, that will because slower heating makes the food tastier. Why? Nutrients, the components won't get deteriorated. But unfortunately, we are cooking in LPG, which is a higher rating thing, and it spoils the food. Okay. Similarly, the way you take food in the pressure cooker, you spoil the food to the point of no return, you know. So, okay, there is another applications I will tell you. This is about heating of the room. Actually, it is not being used nowadays because we are having electric heaters, and this heater were used when Britishers were there, they were using. This is a room heater. So, let me talk about lighting systems. This is, you know, the whatever we use for puja, lamp. And this is a wick also we use. This is your candle light. And this is the lamp, what you use, okay? And this is your lantern, okay? So, we have discussed about some of the applications, and later on, we will be discussing about more of them in the next lecture. But for before that, let me talk about the course content, what I will be covering in this lecture, that is introduction to the combustion, that is definition of combustion, types of fuel and oxidizer, and their properties, types of fuel and various modes of combustion and scope of combustion. And scope of combustion already I have discussed to some extent. And later on we will move to the thermodynamics of combustion, in which we will be reviewing the thermodynamic laws. And we will also learn how we will apply those things for handling the reactant product mixtures, estimate the adiabatic flame temperature, chemical equilibrium and equilibrium products, and the chemistry of combustion. We will be discussing about basic reaction kinetics, elementary reactions, chain reaction, multi-step reactions, right? And simplification of reaction mechanism and global kinetics. Later on, we will move to the physics of combustion, simplified governing equation, but right, and momentum and energy equation, right, mass conservations and multi-component diffusions. Actually, rather I should say, I should discuss basically binary diffusion. And I will be extending to multi-component. I won't be discussing multi-component diffusion. Concept of conserved scalars, you know, if you look at these are the portions, first portion which is preparing yourself to learn the combustion, okay, that's why it is fundamental. So this will basically end the course material. And then as I told earlier that the book, my book, The Fundamental of Combustion, will be basically a textbook, and you can refer these other books like Engineering Thermodynamics, of course you may refer, may not refer, but definitely Kuo, K.K. Kuo, Kenneth Kuo, Principle of Combustion, and S.R. Turns, Introduction to Combustion, Tata McGrail. There are several books by various authors on combustion, you can also refer, okay. I will stop over here, okay, fine. Thank you very much.